One more problem on circles. He says that condition that the two circles x square plus y square plus 2g1x plus 2f1y equal to 0, x square plus y square plus 2g2x plus 2f2y equal to 0 may touch each other. Generally, we can apply the formula c1 c2 equal to r1 plus r2 for the two circles touching each other externally, whereas c1 c2 is equal to r1 minus r2 is going to be the condition for the two circles to touch each other internally. But if you see the problems very carefully, you need not apply this method also. You will get the answer in a very simple method. We observe that the nature of the two circles are touching each other. That means they touch at only one point. And you observe that the first circle as well as the second circle doesn't have any constant. So any circle doesn't have constant means definitely it passes through the origin. So circle number 1 and circle number 2 both are passing through the origin. Of course they touch each other. So touching each other is only one point. That common point is nothing but origin. So they need to touch invariably at 0, 0. Of course the center is -g1, -f1. This is -g2, -f2. If you observe all these three points, c1, point A, and this is c2, all these three points are collinear. When three points are collinear, you can claim slopes are equal. So slope of this one is given by 0 plus f1 by 0 plus g1 is equal to, again slope of this line, 0 plus f2 divided by 0 plus g2. So f1 by g1 is equal to f2 by g2. Cross multiplication, g2 f1 is equal to g1 f2. So whether you can apply this condition or directly this one, you are going to get g1 f2 is equal to g2 f1 in the same manner. According to our options, B is correct answer.